And we are back with Mike Washington from Ivy Lea Construction because we're talking about something that every house has, and that's concrete when you look down. Now, it may be time to update that concrete because it can make such a difference with the look of a house, and that might be the last thing you need to do. Mike is back, and we were looking at some pictures, Mike, and concrete, the nice thing is that, pardon me, you guys are professionals at it. So when it comes to pouring and the depth and the curing, not only do your folks know all about this, but you have so many different varieties to let people know, yeah, you can go this route, but you can go this way as well and add some color.
Yeah, the choices are really endless today. You know, it really starts with once we remove your old concrete, starts with a real good base. We want to get between 2 and 6 inches of crushed stone, and we're going to use a plate vibrator to get it real compacted tight. That's really going to help with slab separation and mm-hmm. and heaving and lifting. The next step is we're going to actually strike off and actually pour the concrete into place. We're going to pour a 4,500-pound mix. The concrete itself is most companies out there pouring 3,500 or 4,000. We've gone the last 2 years to the 4,500. I just think the cement ratio is very important. It's a little higher, gives us a little bit more strength. And then the control joints that you actually cut in the joints, we tool them in, or we'll actually cut them in with a saw after, depending on the application, is also very important. To make sure that all of our concrete is heaving and lifting. It's always going up and down in the winter, and it is going to crack, and we want to place those control joints where we think it's going to crack. And when it does crack, we have the steel reinforcement through the whole slab, so there's no separation, no heaving or lifting, no trip points can ever come about. There's a lot to it. It's mm-hmm. not just yes. throwing concrete down. And you really do want to make sure you're getting a professional or someone that knows what they've been doing and mm-hmm. been in it for a long time.
Right. Yeah. I have a question for you. What if, and I know some people do it here in Western New York, some businesses do it, they have heated driveways?
Yeah, sure, sure.
Do you do that?
Yes, we've done a bunch of those. You can run them off small boilers or even hot water tanks. It's a really nice system. We've probably put 2 or 3 of those in the past couple of years. People are looking for them on larger driveways. They don't even have to get out and shovel anymore.
Isn't that the best?
Yeah, it's unbelievable.
Can you do that with walkways, too?
You can do that with walkways. You can do it with almost anything, long as you have a spot to put the heating unit. Mm-hmm. Usually in the garage ends up being, or in the basement close, somewhere like that.
I think that's the bee's knees.
It is unbelievable.
But you know, when you see the snow come down and then you see it hit the driveway and it instantly melts,
yep.
I'm like, that's for me.
Yeah, exactly. You're not shoveling
right.
off there. And then realistically, you just want to keep the water off it.
Yeah.
That's all you have to do.
Yeah, it's amazing.
Yeah, it's unbelievable.
Take a look now. This looks like a typical city house.
Yeah, this is a city driveway
like
here,
this.
You know, that you're going from house to house. In a lot of these projects, you'll have 9, 10, maybe 11 feet from mm-hmm. house to house. We do a lot of work down in the city. And these, you got to take real care because mm-hmm. You're touching a foundation
right.
Of one house, and you're going all the way to the foundation of the other house, and you're really worrying about water migration here to make sure that you have a nice V going. So mm-hmm. you're actually tipping the water away from each foundation right down the center of that driveway and taking that all the way to the street. There is plenty of room on this one to actually pitch it from the garage all the way to the street, but you got to be very cognizant of mm-hmm. if you look on the right, that's pitched pretty severely to get to that center of the driveway,
yeah.
and then on the left it's pitched over. I mean, you really have to do that.
And every one of the job that you do, there is a professional who's doing that to make sure that the water stays, it's actually running away from the house.
And it's a pretty simple process. We actually set up our transom, and we're actually shooting grade every 10 feet all the way from, in this application from the garage, from the front of that garage, all the way down to the street. So we're moving that water right out of the driveway to the street and keeping specifically in the freeze-thaw cycle toward the end of winter, when the water will actually, and the snow will actually melt during the day,
mm-hmm.
but it freezes at night. So you don't want any ponds or duck ponds,
no.
they'll call them anywhere, that you can slip and fall on.
And Mike, people have a choice of the kind of finish they want, because you might want something a bit smoother
sure.
or a bit rougher. Let's say it's around a pool.
Yep.
You don't want it real smooth because it's going to get more slippery.
Yeah,
when,
you
got to
be very, cognizant around pools, wet areas,
mm-hmm.
if you have small children or elderly people.
Yes.
We're really looking for, high traffic and high concentration of people moving through. You want to have something definitely rougher. You want to have a broom finish on there, exposed aggregate finish. If you are going to have stamped, and some people do in their driveways, there's something we'll put in called shark grip that actually will put a little grip on it. Mm-hmm. It still looks shiny. It will still look nice. It's basically silica sand, but it will give you some traction as you're walking on that with bare feet in the summer or your boots in the winter, that you're not just going to slide and fall.
Right, and that's why you call Ivy Lea, because they remember all of these things to make sure that when this job is finished, it is exactly how you have imagined it.
For sure.
Yeah. And again, think about the durability and think about how long that's going to last. I mean, this is a material that's going to be here.
Yeah, it's really an investment. You know, today, specifically when we're putting in these decorative projects, it is an investment in the curb appeal. And a lot of times we'll laugh about that because you don't see it from the curb. People come around the back of your house and they can't believe what's there. They can't believe the patio or the pool deck that we put in. Like, wow, I would have never imagined this was even back here. It's a beautiful product, and it's just so pretty when it gets shined up. And beginning of the season looks beautiful. It's adding so much value.
Now, Mike, we saw a lot of pictures where things were square, but if somebody would like you to design it, you can design it and make it more curvy.
It could be
anything you want.
We've done several this season already that they're 2 and 3 tiers, and they had all sorts of different curves in them, different angles in them. We had a project out in Lancaster that he wanted his grill to be in a very specific area between a stair and he slid his grill in there, and perfect. Oh. It's just what he wanted, and that's just what, you know, you can do anything, your imagination, and our design team can bring a lot to you too, to say, hey, try this. That we've done in the past, or, you know, we have so many pictures online, give you a lot of good ideas, and then what would make sense for you in your home.
You know, and also if you have the frontage, if you have a nice wide front, maybe you have a country home, and you are, you know, always taking care of the grass, you can actually kill two birds with one stone and make the driveway come in and then go out. You know
for
what I'm
sure.
saying? Have both ways that you can.
Two ways, ingress and egress. It's a beautiful.
Right. Mm-hmm.
It makes things very easy for you. Or we've even done big turnarounds in the top of driveways that if you have enough land, it just makes it simple for you. You know, it makes life easy, and that's what it's about.
And your folks know, do you have enough land for this?
For
can
sure.
Can you do this?
Yeah, we'll get the surveys out. We'll pull all our measurements. Hey, you know, this one doesn't look like we have enough, but we could do this.
Right.
And we'll also always have an alternative idea or plan for you. And then also, too, we do a lot of building in our concrete. You know, we'll put new porches on the front, new porches on the back.
Make another garage, double garage.
Instead of being out of wood, we'll do it in concrete. You never have to worry about it again. I mean, it's just so simple that way. Is it going to cost you a little bit up front? Yes. But again, it's an investment.
Yes.
You're going to get that money back tenfold at the other end. Plus, you're going to enjoy it the whole time you're in that home.
That's right. And that's the important part. For you to enjoy it while you're there. Listen, folks, you can like Ivy Lea on Facebook, and you can also check out their 0% financing for over 24 months.
Yes.
You really make it easy for folks. And if you want to know what other people are thinking, check Angie's List. You'll love what folks have had to say about Ivy Lea.
Sure.
Fantastic.
Sure.
All right, sir, we're going to keep you busy.
Yes,
thank
you.
They're going to have a rewards program that you'll find that out on their website, too. Ivy Lea Construction, located in Tonawanda, New York, but they work all over Western New York. So give them a call at 875-8654. Also, log on and see more pictures like this at ivyleaconstruction.com. And don't forget to like them on Facebook. That's the way it should look, you know?